Hi everyone, in this video I will show you the result of putting together scrap from old printers like this and scanner into 3D printer or so-called rep scrap. Right now we can see how printer is moving to home position. The parts that I bought were extruder, a heated bed, 4 ball bearings, 8mm threaded rod and nuts, a few metal angles, ABS filament, a bunch of 3mm bolts and nuts, Arduino Mega RAMS board with stepper motor drivers, and 3 terminal switches. The ones that I bought has a little wheel that will help during calibration. The list changes I made to a scanner. I cut upper part of a short side to allow platform movement. Then I screw a square piece of MDF on top of a platform. Stepper motors were scraped from old Epson printers and are marked EM462 and EM463 respectively. And a scanner already had a stepper motor with a nice reduction mechanism. Also, I glued parts of aluminium heatsinks and plates to stepper motors with thermal glue to provide sufficient cooling for stepper motors. And I used 4-pair alarm cable to wire all electronics together. And for heated bed I used some thick wire with cross section of 1.5 mm. For X axis I used all print head mechanism, but I cut flat print head holder and mount an extruder on it. Also, I replaced DC motor with a stepper motor from Epson printer. For Z axis were used 2 print head holders with their calibrated shafts that were screwed to both sides of X axis guideline. Also, I welded 2 M8 nuts to metal plates and screwed these metal plates to print head holders. As you can see, shape of this gear is pretty round, but I still need to adjust the amount of filament that goes through extruder to achieve better results. To build this machine, I took apart 4 old printers and 1 scanner. You can use different types of printers and scanners, but first look for old printers, because modern printers don't use stepper motors, they use DC motors. Will, I recommend you to build your own rep scrap. If you have plenty of time, then go for it. Otherwise, just buy a working 3D printer. And if you have questions, please leave a comment. And if this video became popular, maybe I will edit some footage of me building this thing. I hope that you learn something new by watching this video that will help you build your own devices. And, by the way, if you are interested how this machinery sounds.